Hello friends, welcome to LabTechs. My name is Nasir and today I am present with a case study of laptop is not charging, and this is the Dell Vegas motherboard, and I have received motherboard and along with battery. I would like to show you that what is the model here. Now you can see the model number is Dell Vegas Turris, and the processor is Skylake and as well as Kaby Lake. Sometime it comes with 6th generation, 7th generation, 8th generation also. And as you can see here, the part number of the motherboard is 15341-1. One thing that why a motherboard is stop charging. If you talk about this particular question, that the answer would be around 12 to 15 hours, that how many things it is required to charge the battery, because there is the power issue, there may be a signal issue, there may be current issue, there may be limit issue, there may be data clock, there may be temperature issue. So lots of things combined, then your battery start charging. So here I have received a case study, and I would like to demonstrate you today that if any of model you receive for repairing, and whether you have schematic or not, you need to at least check those signals and those pins, which is quite essential to charge the battery. Now let me show you that what is the scenario in this motherboard, and as you will see on the power supply, that what is the load it is going when I inject the DC jack with the battery. Now let's come and see. So guys, as you can see that this is the motherboard, and someone has tried and with a good level, and because I think there was issue, the different issue might be in this motherboard earlier, like as I can see here, the 3.3 and 5 volt regulator is changed. So hopefully when the guy who received this laptop might be dead, and he replaced few of the components and laptop is okay. But it was having some problem, and like laptop is not charging, that is why, and he tried a lot. I would like to show you the component he has changed, like PS ID he has changed, like PS register he has changed, charging IC is changed. There are so many things has been changed. They have tried to some extent, but unfortunately failed to repair the motherboard. So why does this happen? Because you may not have the depth knowledge of the concept. Only the thing is concept. And you need to understand the concept of NVDC technology. You need to understand the concept of HPB technology of the charging. The both technology, unless you understand, like how do you calculate ILIM? How do you figure out that what voltage should be on the IOT pin? And what should be the behavior of the data and clock? And how does it work? How does it communicate? There are so many things which are required. Today, I would like to demonstrate one of the problem among them, whatever I have mentioned, that you may receive various types of problem and you may have solved the various types of cases. But today, one trick I would like to share with you guys, because as you love us too much, you comment on the YouTube, and we, the LabTechs family, are very thankful to all of you, because you really appreciate our videos and you like our videos. That is why. One thing I would tell you, whether you have a schematic or you don't have a schematic, you must check this particular communication. That is the SM bus communication. If you skip that, this particular point, you may not be able to repair the charging case. This is the first signal after the power in. You need to check, because controller IO, SIO tells the charging IC to charge the battery. If the battery is not charging, in that case, maybe the communication is not proper, or the bad communication, maybe the bus interruption, there are the so many things could be possible reason the battery is not being charged. Now, let me inject the DC jack into the motherboard. So it is the Dell. So I need to take out the Dell PSID. And this is the PSID I am going to use here, because PSID is something which is required to charge the HP and Dell laptop. These all are the PSIDs I am using instead of using the adapter. So different types of PSID comes, like for 65 watt, for 90 watt, 45 watts. So here I have normally one PSID for 65 watt, and I am going to use here. Let's see what is the scenario. As soon as I inject here, I need to increase the voltage now. Why do I need to increase the voltage here? Because look, AC detect is decided here. It is 0.017 milliamp. And it indicates us that the threshold of AC detect is not proper. That is why 19 volt or the DC in voltage will not go into the motherboard. In that case, what you need to check, if you are checking with the power supply, you sometime have to increase the voltage level, sometime you have to decrease. Some of the cases I have repaired where my customer says that on the power supply, it is working on the 16 voltage only, not in the 20 volt. With adapter, it is not working, but as soon as I am reducing voltage level, so that is the problem of AC detect. AC detect is something which is telling to the charging IC that adapter input is valid. If adapter input is valid, then you will get a proportion of that voltage against your DC in. If everything is okay, then AC okay logic you get as per requirement. It may be high, it may be low. It depends on the IC, what IC is used in the motherboard. Now, in this motherboard, because I don't remember that name. Now, let me increase the voltage here. As soon as I increase the voltage, it has ampere has increased up, and I can only guess here that the battery is not getting charged. Why? Because if it start charging, then you will get higher ampere, like the current consumption will start occurring on this point. But here there is a no load. Without battery, let me check. Let me remove the without battery, the same 0.27. With battery, without battery, both are same. 0.33 is maximum limit. It is going. It means that the power supply is telling us that no current is going to be consumed by the battery. It is on the standby only. You can, and the standby 3.3, 5 volt, your 1 volt, and 1.8 volt is present on the motherboard in this particular model. Now, if you start checking from the beginning, the few thing you need to always check. Look, I'm sorry to say this thing, that the charging concept, we have made the video of 12 to 15 hours. There we have described all about the internal logic. Unless until you know about the internal logic of the charging IC or any IC, like 3.3 and 5 volt regulator, like RAM regulator, like a V-core regulator, if you have no information about the internal logic, that what is their functionality, how does that work, how does they start, if you have no information about that, you may not repair with the confidence. So it is very required thing. If you are required to enhance your knowledge of the ICs and the communications logic of the motherboard, then you can contact us on the given number for the video course, because we have made the videos as per the demand that you cannot come to India and you need to stay here 4 to 5 months in order to learn these things. So from your home, you can learn. We have prepared that kind of video, and hopefully you will learn, because most of the guys across the world is learning these things. We are getting the positive response. That is why I am suggesting you, if you are required that video, you can contact on the given number. Now, one thing I would like to show you, that the basic principle of charging, where should you begin if you have a schematic? And later I will tell you that if you don't have a schematic, then how you can repair. So this is the schematic diagram of that particular model, this model, Vegas. Here I need to search the charging IC number, and the number is PU4401. Now we have reached on the charging IC. Okay. So this is the charging IC, and the number is ISL 95521AHRZ. Here, we must have experience of these things. The earlier we used to see charging IC with 20 pins, and before that we used to see 32 pins, and now the charging has increased again 32 number. So what is the difference now? In earlier motherboards, like Core 2D motherboards, you used to see a Max IC and ISL IC 32 pins, where you used to get that error amplifier input, error amplifier output. You have to charge enable. These types of signals you used to get on the outside. It is compact now, and all the error amplifier input, output, and feedback, these types of things has been embedded into the charging IC. And now again it is 32 pin, just because there is a monitoring has been increased. The monitoring pins has been increased. Like as you can see here, the proc hot signal is new. Okay, U adapter I is new. You will see so many difference in the new charging IC. Okay, like comp in, comp out, these types of this current measurement, actually these pins are the for the current measurements. Now the measurement and accuracy has been increased. That is why now again 24 to 32 pin number has been increased in the latest generations charging IC. Now the basic thing, the first thing you should check in every motherboard, that VIN voltage is proper or not. So in every architecture, in every charging IC, you need to check that the DC in voltage must be proper. Also, you have to check it that whether the current limit is proper or not. So how do you figure out the current is proper or not? One thing you have to remember, that Ohm's law tells you that V is equal to I into R. Okay. And R is equal to V by I, and I is equal to V by R. Sorry for bad writing. Now, what does happen? You always see a 10 ohm resistor is located on the VIN path. Here, I need to check the DC in. You will see the some few amount of resistor would be located here, 4D7. Okay. This is the resistor located here, and power charge region. This is the power charge region. You have to confirm that this is the DC in. I think this is not DC in. This is the DC in. Cut now, go. So here, if you pay attention here, that this is the DC in, and that resistor which I told you, sometime you will see 2R2, sometime you will find 4R7, sometime you will find out 10 ohm maximum. I have seen 20 ohm with the parallel. So with the parallel, 20 ohm is equal to 10 ohm. So this is the very sensitive resistor. If the current flows too much high, and sometime it is blown up, and this blown up cause the proper voltage but less current. And this also caused to stop charging your battery. So you must pay attention. The first important thing, you have to always be careful about this, that you must check the DC in register value in cold checking. Without power, you have to check so that you can confirm that whatever the what amount of the current will pass across that resistor would be absolutely right. Now, this is the one area, first area we need to check here. And then I will show you the what the value I am getting here. Okay, the first I'm telling you the few pins which is required to check this thing. Since it is the not charging, that is why we need to check these points. This is the one number. The second we need to check here that the AC in must be as per the proportion, whatever the voltage coming through the adapter voltage to through this resistor, it is coming into this. So you have to check this particular AC in signal or AC detect signal, and then you will get the region or VDD and something voltage you will get 5 to 6 volt. It is as per the charging IC. Sometime you will get 6 volt. In some of the architecture, you get 5.4 volt and 5.5 volt. So this is the VDDP region voltage, 6, maybe 6 volt and 5 points in some architecture, 5 volt you will get. So this is the first LDO you get on the motherboard before the 3.3 and 5 volt. So what is the limit level? That if the VCC is around 3.7 volt, if you get 3.7 volt, how you can achieve this voltage? Voltage DC in, if greater than 3.7 volt and your AC in is equal to 0.6 volt, then it will be out from the over voltage or under voltage lockout. So you can achieve this 5 to 6 volt on this point. This is the requirement, first requirement. As per ratio, actually DC in is the ratio. Here I was setting 17 volt, but despite I was not getting the DC in voltage, that is a different thing. Here is to achieve the LDO voltage from the charging IC, this is the minimum level you can set. Maybe you can see this particular charging IC in the tab, sometime where the 12 volt charger is used. Sometime you can see this particular charging IC in the mobile where the 5 voltage DC in is used. As per proportion, they will set this divider so that you will achieve that amount of AC in that will generate your VDDP voltage. Is that clear? Now, the other thing that if you achieve this voltage, if you don't achieve this voltage, you cannot expect to have the AC OK logic. Then you will achieve the AC OK. AC OK is what? AC OK is the certificate of the AC OK is the certificate of power OK, which is telling that to controller IO that whatever the I am receiving the power from the adapter is valid, is okay. This is telling to controller IC. Every time you check it, it must reach. It is not that you just check on this pin number 2. You should check it on the pin number, whatever is going on the controller IO, your SIO. There you have to check this. It must reach. Like here, it is a 0 ohm, however the pad is there, sometime through the 0 ohm, it go across and reach to the controller IO. Now, then we will receive AC drive. If there is the AC drive technology, like as I told you, there are the various types of technology is used. Or if it is the P channel, here is the P channel, then it will through the AC in or AC OK signal, it will create a voltage divider which will reduce the gate voltage. Then your adapter voltage will pass with the appropriate current and it will charge the battery. What does happen? Why I'm telling so many things here to check these things and these things? Just because you see here, if you pay attention, this is the very critical issue. Most of you may not have paid attention if you are new in this line, that if you cut this point, if you just cut this point, remove both resistor from here, or remove this also, still you will get 20 volt around here. So you won't care about this. Okay, I am here having 20 volt and I am also getting the 20 volt here. But actually, if you pay attention here, if you inject 20 volt, exact 20 volt on this point, you will definitely get 19.3 voltage on this point. Why? Just because through this diode, it is passing and the diode will keep 0.7 volt, you know, inside itself, and you will receive the rest of the voltage, 19.3. And current, as far as the current is concerned, it will reduce the current level and it will not allow to charge the battery. So if your laptop is having 19 volt or DC in voltage, make sure that it is getting voltage through the diode mode or with the switching as the biasing is set. Like for the P-channel biasing, here it is P-channel biasing, it is using a divider, it will get a less voltage, like 8 to 9 volt it will get, then it will switch on. So the biasing is required here in order to charge the battery. So these things we will confirm here, and rest, the communications, which is most important things and most required thing to charge the battery, we will look for that. Now let's begin from the basic.